Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up advanced settings in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also find a link below this video to our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Setting up advanced settings is important because most of what's here will be used as default settings for your financial reports, like your profit and loss statement, balance sheet, and cash flow statement. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. To begin, after you sign into your QuickBooks Online account, click on the gear icon and select Account and Settings. Go ahead and click on the Advanced tab on the far left. And the first section that we want to edit is accounting. Click the pencil icon in the far right-hand corner to edit this information. The accounting feature allows you to enter the fiscal year for your business. In general, most businesses use the calendar year January 1st through December 31st. However, if your business uses a different fiscal year, then you would note that here. The first month of the income tax year would typically be the same as the first month of your fiscal year. The accounting method that you use also needs to be indicated here. There are two methods, cash and accrual. Most small businesses use the cash method. If you are not sure which method you use, refer to your tax return or contact your tax professional. Let's save our changes. Company type is the next area that we need to edit. You will need to select how your company is organized in this section. If you are not sure how your company is organized, click this link to our article on company organization. The options that you have to choose from here are sole proprietor, partnership, small business corporation, which is typically an S-corp, a corporation, nonprofit organization, or limited liability corporation. Paul files a Schedule C with his tax return, so he is a sole proprietor. Let's save our changes here. The next section is the chart of accounts. The chart of accounts allows you to enable account numbers. This feature will allow you to assign an account number to all of your accounts. Most accountants tend to use this feature, but it is not commonly used by non-accountants. Unless you have been given a chart of accounts that your accountant wants you to use, I recommend that you leave this feature off. Discount account. In the How to Set Up QuickBooks Online Invoices, Sales Receipt, and Estimates lesson, we walk through how to turn on the discount feature. If you activated this feature, then you want to be sure to assign a discount account here. If you did not set up a discount account, you can do so from this screen. Just click the drop down and scroll up to select Add New. Be sure to watch our video tutorial on how to set up the chart of accounts to learn how to create a new account. Let's save our changes here. Categories allows you to track classes and location. Class tracking allows you to categorize income and expenses by department or product line. Once you turn this feature on, it will add a class field to all sales and expense forms. Be sure to mark the checkbox that says, "Warn me when a transaction isn't assigned a class." QuickBooks will let you know if you forget to assign a class to a transaction. You also have the option to select one class per transaction, or select one class per line item in a transaction like an invoice. Tracking locations allows you to categorize income expenses by location, like stores or sales region. Once you turn this feature on, it will add a location field to all sales and expense forms. Let's go ahead and save our changes here. Automation is the next section. This feature allows you to activate several areas. The first one is pre-fill forms with previously entered content. This feature will automatically complete the fields on any form in QuickBooks based on the last saved transaction for that customer, vendor, or employee. A word of caution here. While this feature might save you a few keystrokes, be sure that the information is copied over correctly. For example, if the invoice date or amount is different from the last transaction, you will need to update those fields with the correct information. In Paul's business, time is money. If he can save even a few minutes here and there, it's worth it. He's going to go ahead and allow QuickBooks to pre-fill his forms so that all he has to do is make changes to just the fields that are different. Automatically apply credits is the next feature below that. This feature will automatically apply credits to the next invoice you create for the same customer. For example, if you overcharge a customer for something, then you need to create a credit memo in QuickBooks for that customer. By turning this feature on, QuickBooks will automatically apply the credit to the next invoice that you create for that customer so that the amount that they owe is reduced by the credit that is applied. If you don't turn this feature on, you will have to manually apply any outstanding credits to customer invoices. Automatically invoiced unbilled activity. This feature will automatically create an invoice for your customer for unbilled items. Paul would like to leave this feature off, and he will determine when to bill his customers for unbilled items. Copy estimates to invoices. With the click of a button, this feature will allow you to quickly create an invoice by copying the items from an estimate that your customer has approved. Turning on this feature is definitely worth the keystrokes it will save you. Automatically apply bill payments. This feature automatically applies your payments to the oldest existing bill that you have entered into QuickBooks for a vendor. For example, when you create a payment for a vendor, you typically want to pay the oldest bill first. By turning this feature on, QuickBooks will automatically apply your payment to bills in the order they become due. This will ensure that your bills are paid by their due date. Let's go ahead and save our changes here. The time tracking feature will allow you to easily manage hours that your contractors work, and it makes it easy to bill your customers back for that work if you need to. Paul bills customers by the hour, so this feature will help him to easily bill his customer for the right hours once the job is complete. Currency. This feature lets you track transactions in foreign currencies. You would only use this feature if you have bank accounts, customers, or vendors that don't use your home currency. Let's go ahead and save our changes. Other preferences allows you to set up several general features here. It allows you to set up the date format. It allows you to format your numbers in QuickBooks. It will warn you if a duplicate check number is used when paying a vendor. You can set up a customer label. So if you like to refer to your customers as something other than customers, so donors or clients, you are able to make that selection here. You can also set it up so that QuickBooks will warn you if a duplicate check number is used. And QuickBooks will warn you if a duplicate bill number has been used by your supplier. The last but not least, you are able to tell QuickBooks to sign you out after a certain period of time has passed for inactivity. The default is set to 1 hour, but you can increase that up to 3 hours. Go ahead and save our changes. That wraps up the section on setting up advanced settings. To access this course or any of the others in the series, or for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online, click the links below this video. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.